Fire.
Hi guys, Napizon is here. Welcome to another episode how to make the ace in World of Tanks. If you are not interested in making the ace, surely this will help you to perform better in the game. This time I picked the tier 4 American turreted tank destroyer, the M8A1, also known as a pocket Hellcat. It is considered the best tank destroyer for its tier. This is the first tank destroyer from the American turreted tank destroyers line. Except the armor, this tank has everything: speed, camo, DPM and view range. The M8A1 is very flexible, but is better to be used as a support vehicle. So let's go to the tactic to see the position of the M8A1. To get the M8A1, you will start with the T3HMC, a very fast tank at tier 2. At tier 3 we have the T56GMC with a very good mobility and unlocks the way to the M8A1 at tier 4. So let's see how we upgrade this tank. We gonna put the second pair of tracks that has 40 travel speed, the last engine with 350 horsepower, the last radio with 750 meter signal range, the last turret with 320 meter view range, 18 traverse speed and with 38 mm frontal armor. And from these four guns we gonna put this one, the 57 mm M1 gun. This gun has 110 mm of penetration with AP and it costs 50 credits per shell. 180 mm of penetration with the gold round and that is APCR and it costs 2800 credits per shell. And 29 mm of penetration with the HE and it costs 28 credits per shell. The damage with the HE is 95 and with the AP and APCR is 75. The accuracy is not very good, 0.39. The aiming time is awesome, 1.7 seconds. The rate of fire is very good, 24. And the gun depression is minus 10 degrees, characteristic for the Americans. After upgrading the tank, let's see now the general stats. The M8A1 has 265 hit points, the second lowest after the Soviet Su-85B. Let me see. 260 hit points. And in the opposite side is the French Somua SA-40 with 280 hit points. The M8A1, it weighs almost 16 tons, fully equipped. It has an engine with 350 horsepower, that means almost 22 horsepower per ton. The top speed is very good, 58 kilometers per hour. The travel speed is very good too, 40 degrees per second. As you can see, this tank destroyer is extremely mobile. So, let's see the armor. The hull is 29 mm on the front, 29 mm at the sides and 25 mm at the rear. The turret is 38 mm on the front, 25 mm at the sides and 25 mm at the rear. So no effective armor on this tank destroyer. My XVM mod is calculating 2.16 seconds the gun actual reload time. The turret travel speed is very bad, 18 degrees per second. Very standard view range for a tier 4 tank destroyer, 320 meters, but with the crew skills and equipment increases to 400 meters. The M8A1 has the best signal range from the tier 4 tank destroyers, 750 meters, and with the crew skills and equipment increases to 782 meters. I'm not gonna check the M8A1's armor in the tank inspector because his armor is not effective. So, the first step after upgrading the tank is the crew skills. The M8A1 has a crew of 4 members. The commander, the gunner, the driver and the radio operator. The gunner is also the loader. So, the two most important skills in the game are Sixth Sense and Brother in Arms. As you can see guys, I don't have crew skills on this tank because the Brother in Arms is just on 92% and it will be activated only when it reaches 100%. The second step is the equipment that is here. We gonna put the gun rammer for faster reload, the camouflage net active when the vehicle is stationary, and the binocular telescope that gives plus 25% view range active when the vehicle is stationary. The third is the exterior. Because I keep this tier 4 permanently in my garage, I bought permanent paint and inscription with gold. I apply camouflage for winter, summer and desert. And I put this inscription. Devastator, because this tank is a wrecking ball. This paint gives the tank plus 4% better camo values. The fourth step is the consumables, which are here. We gonna put small repair kit, large first aid kit that gives plus 15% protection of the crew from injuries, and the automatic fire extinguisher that gives plus 10% to fire protection. With these combinations that you see here, you have to make these. So, let's see this tank in action.
Let's get this show on the road.
Welcome to the replay. The map is swamp. And as you can see, I'm top tier. The DPM is awesome for a tier 4 tank destroyer, 1800 with 100% major qualifications of the crew and without equipment, of course. I used to carry 60 regular ammo and 6 gold shells, that is 66 rounds, and that is a total of 4950 damage. In this kind of matchup, it is enough to kill alone the entire enemy team. You will see that in this kind of maps, where a lot of bushes, this tank is like the big white shark in the ocean. It's lurking the prey and jumps on it. This is my very first ace with this tank. I can see the murder too, a good shot in him and burn baby. The Valentine is next. 1, 2. A miss. 3, 4, and this is my first kill of the game. As you can see, these tanks quickfire and aiming time pay the price. I put a nice shot into the DW2, another one, but he pulls back behind that rock. We are leading with 5-3. The constant changes of the situation. Now we are behind with one tank. The score is 6-7. Oh boy, I missed the Covenanter. And he goes to shelter. Finally it worth my patience. I killed the DW2. Come on, Covenanter. Taste my gun. 1, 2. I think 3. The score is once again in our favor now. It's 10-8. Come on, T-28, give me your long and juicy side. One. A miss. Oh boy, another one.
Where'd they go?
The bushes have efficiently hidden my tank till now. Now is the time to use this tank speed. Nice shot from the back, and this is my third kill of the game. Nice job, Sneaky T-82. You just waited for me. But too bad that you are not using the troll gun, because my rapid fire shot my fourth kill of the game. Let's hunt down the remaining two enemies. So we spotted the Hetzer. He's giving me his side. One. Two. Come on. And no driving license, he crashed. I spotted the arty and boom! Amorak, we finished this game in style. I hope that in this replay I was able to point out the great camo, mobility and rapid fire gun of this tank. Let's see now the postgame stats. So here is our mastery badge, Ace Tanker, and also we managed to pick up the high caliber medal for all the damage done in this game. We got 5,725 experience with the premium account thanks to our triple time event. We managed to give 1,473 damage, we picked up 5 kills and we received 1,018 basic experience. Shots fired, 35, direct hits 21, 21 penetrated. And also we managed to do 347 spot damage. Personally, I really like this tank because it has a very good gun, mobility and camo. That's why I always kept it in my garage. What about you guys? Do you like the M8A1? Please share your thoughts in a comment below. Thank you guys for watching, I hope you enjoyed this. Good luck on the battlefield and see you in the next episode.